Good evening, and welcome to the 7th Chicago Jazz String Summit. We are so happy that you have decided to spend this evening with us, which just happens to be International Jazz Day. We have an exciting lineup for you over the next couple of evenings, celebrating a wide variety of improvising styles. This event celebrating innovative string players began in 2013, and I am so pleased that it has been able to continue. Normally, we present live sets at Chicago venues Constellation, Elastic, and The Hungry Brain, but for the second year in a row, I am so grateful to partner with Experimental Sound Studios. Thank you, ESS, for your support and for all that you folks are doing for the Chicago community and the world. Every year, we pay tribute to an innovative string player, and this year, the Chicago Jazz String Summit is dedicated to cellist and composer Deirdre Murray. We will hear from her in little interview snippets over the next couple of evenings. Thank you for being a role model to me and so many others, Deirdre. So, before we begin, I'd like to thank a few folks. Violist and composer Melanie Dyer, thank you so much for your words, encouragement, enthusiasm throughout this whole process this year. Thanks to Marley Simmons and Ray Alvarez for your amazing website and graphics work. Thanks to Sean Madigan for helping with the social media. And thanks to Nzinga Kendall for some last-minute video editing. Also, thank you New Music USA for your support this year, Mills College for hosting our workshops, and to Make Music NOLA, Blue Mountain Music, and Hyde Park Suzuki. Thanks also to David Brown and Jean Cook, and to all of you who have donated in the past and who we hope will donate in the future. This really is a labor of love, so if you like what you hear, please feel free to donate. All proceeds go to paying artist fees, promotion, tech, everything. And I'm hoping we'll be live next year, so all those donations will really help. So without further ado, welcome, and thanks for joining us. Tonight we will hear from Leyla, McCalla, cellist and vocalist, Judith, Insell, and Joe Fonda on viola and bass, Sam Bardfeld and Chess Smith on violin and drums, and harpist Brandee Younger. Thank you.
Hey, everybody. I'm really excited to have been asked, honored to have been asked to be part of the Chicago Jazz. I'm in my home in New Orleans, Louisiana, and I'm going to play you some songs on my cello. An all cello set, which is kind of different for me. I play banjo and guitar as well, but really cello is home for me. So I want to start with a song from a Creole fiddler named Kenry Fontenot. This one's called Les Places sont tu mis sur la table, and I'm going to be singing in Cajun French. That means where all the plates on the table are set. So the first verse says, where can I find a do-nothing job? Second verse says, where can I find a woman who's hungry when I'm hungry? And the third verse says, where can I find the plate set on the table at my house?
Thank you.
me, les plats sur me, sur la table de ma maison. Un jour, va rien faire, où je vais aller pour trouver les plats tout mis sur la table. Où je vais aller pour trouver les plats tout mis sur la table de ma maison. Sorry, excuse my hand. I'm going to try to figure out how to back up my camera a little bit so you can see my bow hand a little bit better. Like if I'm going to do a streamed performance, I should try to make sure y'all can see my hand. who's tired of COVID? I am. I guess there was an option for me to submit a pre-recorded video, but I kind of felt like just even if you can't feel who's watching you, it feels better somehow to do it in real time, you know, in real virtual time, whatever time that is. But just a side note, So I'm at my house in New Orleans. I've lived in New Orleans for over 10 years now, and really it's been a place for me to incubate a lot of my creative ideas. And, you know, when I moved here, I was making my living by playing Bach on the street, on Royal Street, busking. And it really helped me to write songs and work on arrangements and kind of, I learned how to play banjo during that time. And I did a lot of research about New Orleans, and it really connected me to my Haitian heritage. And so there's a lot of, kind of, you know, a lot to explore, I think, in all of that. And one of the miracles of this last year is that I got to re-release my first record, called Very Colored Songs, which was released in tribute to Langston Hughes originally in 2014. And so I want to continue by playing a couple songs that I really, really kind of honed in my first years of living in New Orleans. The first couple of songs are settings of poems by Langston Hughes, who's an artist who's been really influential in my life. This one's called Girl. She lived in sinful happiness and she died in pain. She danced in sunshine and laughed in rain. She went one summer morning where the flowers ran the plain. She told everybody she'd be coming back again. Folks hammered her coffin. Folks built her a coffin. And they hid her deep in the earth. Seems like she said, my body brings new birth.
Thank you.
You know, one of the things that I kind of learned in my research about Langston Hughes is that one of his first travels outside of the United States was to Haiti. And Haiti is where my family's from, and it's become a big part of my work to explore my Haitian roots and, you know, through my cello playing and songwriting and learning a lot about Haitian history and kind of, you know, understanding the relationship, the historical relationship between Haiti and Louisiana and the United States at large has been really kind of affirmative in understanding some of my own personal experience as a Black woman navigating the world and trying to understand my place in it. So I want to sing for you the first song that I learned to play in Haitian Creole. This is a song that comes from a tradition of music called troubadour music. And this style of music is a lot of social and political commentary, and I found that really interesting. And it's called La Tibonite. It's a classic Haitian folk song. And it says, when I go to the valley, they tell me that the sun is ill and is lying still. I went to go see the sun. I found the sun was sleeping. And when I came back, I found the sun had died, and it hurts my heart to have to bury the sun. I just thought that was so devastating and poetic, and I've been singing this song ever since.
Say
I'll play you a song that I wrote called When I Can See the Valley. Well, I'm praying because I'm scared that my time is coming soon. And I pray because I feel that I've got too much to lose. When your savior came a knocking, were you ready to be free? And would you ask her up in heaven to say, but I am afraid to fly. We all want to go to heaven, but no one wants to die. And I'm choosing to be faithful, to have something to hold on to. But when I can't see the valley, I'll begin my search for you. I'm going to play another Cajun song. I discovered Camry Fontenot, I guess shortly after moving to New Orleans. He was from Southwest Louisiana, more near Lafayette area. And he just, you can find his videos on YouTube, but he just had a pretty indefatigable spirit, and his playing was really special, and I got really curious about, I was kind of starting to play more old-time music on cello, and I just fell in love with Cajun music and Creole music, and I found, this style of music called La-La, which is kind of the antecedent to Zydeco. Some people call it Black French music, but in any case, Camry Fontenot is a big part of that tradition here, and I learned this song from a recording of him playing it. It's called the Jogo Plombo, and it's kind of a drinking song, and it's kind of a breakup song, and so the song says, I'm drinking my jug of whiskey, my jug of plumbo, and I'm crying and I'm praying just to see your pretty face. You hurt me so much, and it's all your parents' fault that we can't be together. If we can't get along, you can thank your mother, and if I never see you again, you can thank your father. ¶¶ C'était pour atteindre sa figure. Oh, Timon, toi tu me fais de la peine. On a eu pour se séparer. C'était la cause à tes parents. Si on était si mal d'accord, c'est la cause à ta maman. Si on a eu pour se séparer, tu peux m'essayer à ton papa. Si on était si mal d'accord, c'est la cause à ta maman. Si on a eu pour se séparer, tu peux m'essayer à ton papa. So I'm going to play one more song for you, and this song was the title track to my second record. It's a song called A Day for the Hunter, A Day for the Prey. Thank you. If they take me away, I want you to pray, not for me, for the souls who have been taken like me before. If I am the same, I want you to pray, not for me, for the souls who have stayed like me before. Day for the hunter, day for the prey. 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 Everybody, thank you everybody for listening, for tuning in to this wonderful night of music organized by the Chicago Jazz String Summit. I'm super honored to be a part of it. My name is Leyla McCalla, and I hope to see you all in person in the future. Bye.
Well, welcome to the 7th annual Chicago Jazz String Summit. Every year we do a tribute to an innovative string player, and I'm so honored to have cellist, composer, extraordinaire Deirdre Murray with us. She has definitely been an inspiration for me, hearing her play in so many different ensembles and listening to recordings as I was, you know, looking for, you know, role models and players in this music. So I'm so honored, Deirdre, that you agreed to chat with us today. And I want to start out by asking you, how did you get started playing cello?
Well, first of all, thanks for having me. My mother and my aunt were dancers, and they were always talking about the arts. And I was a musical child. I mean, I was kind of music crazy. They used to have a toy called Melody Bells. I used to play them. I mean, I can remember being fascinated by music when I was 4 or 5, anything that made sound. And I watched this Betty Davis movie where she was in love with a conductor, and she was, I think she played the violin or something like that. And I said, I want to do that. And when here in the old public school system in New York City, they used to, you know, put you in orchestras if you had talent for it. I got into an orchestra, and they gave me a cello, and that's how it started.
And did you ever think that you would become a composer or do improvised music? Like, can you talk about what came first? Did you start improvising before you start composing, or were you always writing pieces or always improvising?
Well, my memory of it is that I didn't know how to tune, so I made my own tuning. You know, so in other words, they give you an instrument in the school, and you maybe have 2 weeks before you have an orchestra class. So I tuned it, you know, and I made my own tuning. And my aunt came, I'll never forget this, to the house and said, I'm gonna do this movement, play something. So I started making sound. So I actually was improvising before I knew anything about how to really play the cello. I started as an improviser.
This piece is entitled Song for My Mother. It's a melody that came to me while my mother was leaving this dimension, going to the next. I've been playing it ever since. It's entitled Song for My Mother.
Thank you.
that we will play is a dedication to a colleague and a mentor of mine, one of America's great musicians, Mark Whitecage. Mark recently passed on, but we continue to play his music and the music we've written for him. So this is called In the White Cage. Thank you.
So this piece is entitled Bill. It's dedicated to the memory of my father, William Insell, who everybody knew as Bill. And it's a very special meaning to me as I lost him many years ago.
Thank you.
What was your first jazz gig?
Well, I was in a band in high school, and we were trying to get a record contract because I was in a band with my cousin, my aunt's daughter, and we all sang, and we were doing like what we thought was folk rock, but we went to rehearsal studio, and there were some jazz musicians. They said, "That's not folk rock, that's jazz." I didn't know the categories. But of course it makes sense because I was a kind of a self-made musician. So on one hand, you learn the classical catalog. On the other hand, my real life as a musician, you know, but I was doing gigs when I was very young. I mean, like, I don't know, 9, 10, 11, with my aunt.
Wow. What is it that you like about improvisation? Is there something, you know,
I think for a long time I couldn't separate it. And I made a very bad classical musician because I always thought I had a better idea than the composer. So you know you learn the Bach 6 suites, right? That's how I used to practice. And you know my teachers used to just shake their head. Because I really didn't have, because I started as an improviser, I really didn't understand for a long time, this is this, and that is that. I really, it all always flowed all the time.
One, two, three. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Let's talk about actually performing the cello, because as we know, it's a very physical instrument, and you know, carrying the instrument while you're traveling, these heavy flight cases, and you know, I know this is something that you want to address, and I think is really pertinent to talk about as self-care as a string player, because we're using these really fine motor skills or these really small muscles and everything. What advice would you have? Or,
well, I would say that something that I never learned, that for, let's say, for every 2 hours that you sit, because sitting, you know, we need to sit, but it can be really bad for you. And you think about all the years you could play and all the years that you're practicing, that for every maybe 2 hours of playing, you need to do at least a half an hour of exercising, stretching, walking, something that builds the muscles so that later on in your career, you'll have a lot less injury. Because I had many pinched nerves, all kinds of things. And I remember, you know, holding the bow and also playing with amplifiers and things like that. I could hardly hold a spoon sometimes, you know, because of, I don't constantly gripping and the tension and release. So I would say that spend a much more time on your physical self outside of playing. You know, just remember every time you do a gig, I don't know, but I used to practice all the time. You know, I would practice before, you know, let's say in high school, 2 hours before, you know, I went to a school for the arts, playing in school, 2 hours afterwards. You know, I was always practicing because I also loved it, but that's a lot of wear and tear on your body. So I would say, you know, do something that helps your physical being.
Hello, I'm Brandee Younger, and I'm really thrilled to be part of the Chicago Jazz String Summit. Thank you, Tomeka Reid, for inviting me. I hope that we can do this in person in the future. This is an original composition entitled Essence of Ruby. Thank you.
Thank you.
Actually two movements from a larger suite that I compose. This is the first and second movement of the 2020 suite, Shelter in Place and Unrest.
Thank you.
if you hear the sounds of the neighborhood, that's exactly what it was like to be sheltered in place, with the sounds of the neighborhood still happening. So here we are in Harlem, and this is Unrest. you so much for having me, and Tomeka, thank you for putting this together. I'm really excited that we're able to be together even though we're apart. Looking forward to being in the same place again very soon. This is John Coltrane's Wise One.
Thank you. Thank you.